Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Innovation Days on my behalf also. My name is Sami Kelin, and I'm the responsible for the flat tempering products in Glaston heat treatment. Today, let's have a quick look at the latest trend. We will also have a look at the digitalization, where we are on that one, how it's going to serve everyday production in flat tempering point of view. And then we are going to have a look at where we are on the autopilot itself and actually have our customers' comments on that one also. Single one topic on the trends is simply the efficiency. From production point of view, this means less batches for the same throughput of the orders. Practically, this means that we need to have higher bed utilization on each batch, and where it goes from there is the fact that we need to be able to tolerate bigger size differences in same loadings. As the process is size sensitive, it practically means that we need to be able to focus heat in very specified areas of the furnace according to the glass sizes. On the same point of view, energy efficiency is simply increased by having higher bed utilization as we are spending less energy in the chiller for the glasses. Earlier this year, we started a new tempering line in Netherlands at our customer Steinfort Glass. Let's hear what their CEO, Mr. Janan Jema, has to say about that.
Steinfort Glass is a glass processing company in the Netherlands, and we employ about 80 people. We specialize in single-piece architectural and interior glass products. We do a lot of variation in products. We temper products, we print, we roller coat, we laminate, and but we do that with a lot of variation. The relationship between Steinfort and Glaston is a very long existing relationship. Actually, in 1999, we bought our first Glaston tempering furnace. The machine has been in operation for more than 20 years and is now replaced by a new Glaston furnace. The reason to go with Glaston is that they shared our belief that it is possible to develop a fully autonomous tempering process. In fact, our furnace has some elements of self-learning aspects in the controls, and they put a lot of effort in it, not only in their own company. We know that they cooperate with universities and so on, and that's important to us, that we have the process for the future. The consistency of the quality is better because the operator does not have to interfere all the time. Especially companies who want a high quality, consistent production and high volume with the possibility of a lot of variation. That's the company that should consider that.
Digitalization has changed the way we have been working for the last years. In flat tempering and heat treatment, we have many quality aspects. One that can never be off is the fragmentation of glasses. Typically, this is validated by sending a sample piece through the furnace together with the normal production. Sample piece typically is sized about 360 by 1100, which is, of course, considered to be very small comparing to the rest of the orders. All of us who have been working with the tempering lines know that small piece of glass actually gets fragmentation very easily. But what about the bigger sizes? What about the most valuable pieces in the production? How to measure those? You could always measure them by scallop, for example. But our solution is actually something called the stress calculation. It actually follows the glass temperature as it cools down and then predicts the fragmentation and stress levels on the glass. On the screen, you can actually see a view from the online measurement within our user interface, giving green for all the glasses. Having the immediate feedback on the fragmentation is very valuable, as it then enables you to actually take the actions if there is something off in the process. Fragmentation is very concrete. Typically, we simply break the class and then compare the calculated value for the reference, which quite often is 40 or 60. If it's below the reference, there is something wrong. If it's over the reference, everything is OK. But what about the rest of the quality values, especially the ones which we all see slightly differently? As long as I have been in the business, white haze has been something like this. We all see it slightly differently, and even the standards regarding the haze, they all are depending on a human eyesight. At least my eyesight is getting so much worse that I don't see white haze anymore at all. But how to really judge how much there is white haze? We decided to throw the ball to artificial intelligence and actually trained a scanner to detect white haze. It was taught by humans who were evaluating how much white haze there was on the glasses, and then the scanner actually learned from there to give a grade of white haze. This is actually in production in Tampere, in our testing facility at the moment. So far, the results are very exciting. Digitalization is going to change the working environment on the flat tempering lines quite radically. As the intelligence levels are increasing, different components can actually predict when the maintenance is needed. This actually turns the maintenance from preventive maintenance to predictive maintenance. At the same time, operator role is changing. Machines are learning how to actually run the process, how to optimize the process. This is actually changing the operator role from loading the glass, selecting the recipes, fine-tuning parameters, into more of an overhauling, making sure that everything is good on the glass, from the glass flow point of view. Let's have a look what kind of solutions we have been inserting into our latest flat tempering line. Traditionally, tempering lines have been kind of a standalone units within the material flow in a safety class factory. Nowadays, it's going more to the integrations where tempering lines might be integrated to a washing machine or even a loading robot system. At the same time, as I said, operator role is changing. The traditional way of selecting recipe parameters is changing to a way of actually getting the information from ERP or MES systems directly to the tempering line, and tempering line is also communicating back to the ERP systems. Miika already mentioned about the autopilot, and this is something very close to my heart. As we have been talking with the different specialists, we are always wondering how come they all have a little bit different view to the process settings itself. Some of them want to fine-tune, for example, heater power. Some of them want to fine-tune the convection settings. Maybe somebody wants to fine-tune from the cooling part. This actually generates a kind of a magic of tempering, and we want to remove that one. Our solution was actually to remove all the process parameters. For this, we actually generated a process model that reflects how the glass should be heated up and cooled down to maximize the quality. We call it the autopilot, and this actually enables anybody to temper glass as well as possible. This has been in test use at one of our customers in Finland, and let's see what they have to say about that one.
Raklalla on aika pitkä historia jo suomalaisessa lasinjalostuskentässä, ja me on löydetty hyvä oma paikka ja asema siitä. Viime vuosina ollaan varsin vahvasti investoitu konekantaamme etunenässä se, että asiakkaalla on koko ajan enenevissä määrin kasvava tarve suuremmille lasikoille. Innovatiiviset, korkealaatuiset jatkojalustet tuotteet on ehdottomasti Raklan suuri vahvuus, ja niihin ollaan jatkossa entistä enemmän panostamassa. Automaatio on ehdottomasti meidän tulevaisuuteen äärettömän tärkeä asia, ja näin karkasuunin näkökulmasta niin tuotteiden tasalaatuisuus ja toiminnan vakiinnuttaminen on näyttää siinä suurta roolia. Ihmistekijän pienentäminen on isossa vaikutuksessa ja konetyön määrän kasvattaminen. Tavoitellaan sitä tilaa, että kone tekee työn ja ihminen seuraa enemmän kuin ihminen tekee työn ja kone tekee ihmisen mukaan asioita. Operaattorin rooli on Glastonin automaatioteknologian myötä muuttunut sillä tavalla, että ei tarvita enää pitkän linjan osaavaa lämpökäsittelyn ammattilaista. Lasia pystyy tällä hetkellä karkaisemaan mekaanisesti käytännössä kuka tahansa, joka pystyy lasia tuotteena itsessään käsittelemään. Ei tarvita enää kovaa ammattilaisosaamista. Vielä helppouttakin tärkeämpänä pidän kuitenkin yhtenäisyyttä ja toiminnan automatisointia siihen asteeseen, että tehdas toimii samalla tavalla käyttäjästä riippumatta. Raklan tärkein asia yhteistyössä Glastonin kanssa ehdottomasti minun näkemykseni mukaan on tämä tiivis kehitysyhteistyö, jossa olemme saaneet onnekkaasti olla mukana jo vuosia. Meillä on ollut käytössä koko ajan Glastonin uusimmat innovaatiot, ja se on mahdollistanut meidän omankin osaamisen nostamisen lämpökäsittelyn huippuluokkaan Suomessa, ja ollaan myöskin onnistunut säilyttämään asemamme siellä näiden uusien teknologioiden ansiosta. Olen itse toiminut Glastonin lämpökäsittelylaitteiden parissa yli 2 vuosikymmentä, ja suosittelen Glaston yhteistyötä jokaiselle, joka osaa arvostaa laadukkaita tuotteita, ammattitaitoista ja erityisesti palveluhalukasta henkilökuntaa ja ratkaisukykyistä ja nopeaa reagointia asiakkaan tarpeisiin.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was a compact introduction to the latest in flat tempering from Glaston. I'm looking forward for your questions, but meanwhile let's give the table to Mr. Riku Färm, who will lead you to the exciting world of flat laminating. Thank you.